Mr. Chairman, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I am honored to be part of the 5th Global Platform for Disaster Reduction. Disasters are visiting untold suffering on people. The June 3rd flood and fire disaster, a combination that are polar concept which hit Ghana 2 years ago and claimed over 100 lives, is a bitter experience we will all hardly forget. I believe all of us gathered here have one or more bitter experiences to recall. Mr. Chairman, disaster risk is therefore a matter of global concern. However, among the less developed countries, inability to implement risk reduction measures fully is summed up in one word: poverty. We are of the view that poverty has been the main cause of vulnerability in many parts of the world. This being the case implies that disaster risk management in less developed countries will not be meaningful if the core issue of poverty is not leveraged for a more considerable attention at this forum. Even though the first guiding principles of the SFDRR states that each state has a primary responsibility preventing and reducing disaster risk, the fact that disaster risk is a shared responsibility cannot be emphasized. Strong regional and international partnership is necessary to reduce disaster risk in the world, especially looking at the different ability of countries across the world to cope with the disasters. Mr. Chairman, we believe that this situation calls for a critical look at DRR funding within the context of national and international responsibility vis-a-vis abilities. DRR funding should be seen as responsible beyond the domain of individual countries. The fact that a disaster affecting one country could generate socioeconomic implications for others makes looking at risk from the shared approach a step in the right direction. We need pragmatic action on the part of government to mainstream DRR and ensure that DRR policies are implemented. We have to direct our commitment beyond individual national boundaries. Ghana, in this direction, has offered DRR training for 17 West African states in the area of early warning response. It is also worth noting that Ghana has demonstrated commitment by establishing a national disaster fund, which is backed by legislation. This facilitating the implementation of SFDRR, we have mainstreamed the Sendai framework for DRR and SDGs in our overall national development program. We have also set the state to develop a national plan of action to implement the SFDRR. Government has come up with policies to tackle the core issues of poverty. For example, the government has come up with a program dubbed Planting for Food and Jobs to improve income level, reduce vulnerability. Again, re-engineering of drains in our major cities is being considered in very high political circles. Indeed, dealing with disaster risk requires pragmatic approach with robust national agenda to drive home the global targets or goals. The global platform should institute peer review mechanisms of implementation of the Sendai framework for disaster risk reduction. In such a peer review, investment in DRR should be scored or ranked high as measures of development. This will require developing the appropriate indicators in that direction. Mr. Chairman, the time to act is now, for posterity will not forgive us if you continue to make our globe a land and not a home, a burning furnace of hopelessness, rather than a heaven of refreshment. Let us work harder than ever to make our globe resilient and safe. Thank you, and God bless us all.